I mean, I remember like the you know, sort of one of the happiest times was when we were putting together the end titles. We did it bit by bit. Every time I'd write a new theme, I'd run down the corridor because Nick Dodd, who was orchestrating, was in another room at the end of the corridor
with his shirts, right
piano, with his shirts. It was a three shirt day, that's to do with the amount that he perspired during conducting. But
Nick would conduct about 2 hours of conducting, and he'd come into the control room soaked, absolutely soaked through, and we'd have to wait for a moment while he got into shirt number two.
One man wet t-shirt contest.
Yep.
It was unbelievably committed to the art of conducting. And then I went into a couple of people's sessions and I thought, like, well, the conductor's not doing anything. You know, he's just sitting there and you can barely see the baton moving. It's like, it's just this very different. Anyway, you know, we get there the way we get there. But I used to go in with like these new little bits and pieces and we would kind of compile the end titles because we knew it was going to be long. I think there was something like 4,000 people on the credits. And,
right.
You know, I knew it was going to be about 11 minutes long.
Yeah.
And I thought, well, let's do a completely original piece of music rather than doing the usual thing where you kind of, you know, you have a little segue, which after a minute sort of dies away and then you cut into bits of cue from the movie.
Yeah.
So let's do a proper end title suite, you know, and of new, you know, newly written stuff. So I was using all the themes and then we played around with the themes and then we'd finished it and you came over and I said, well, let's play it then. You sat down in the room with me and Nick and we played it just on a piano. You know, I mean, like the actually, Robert, there were very few properly mocked up cues in those days, you know, because the equipment wasn't as sophisticated as it is now. And I didn't have much of it anyway. So it was quite basic, I think, you know, we did about four or five or six, maybe major cues. The president's speech was the one that got the most attention, I think. Hmm. So that was mocked up as effectively and as completely as possible, before anything else happened. That was when I had the most discussion with Dean Devlin about, certainly. And interestingly, this week, so many international presidents have been making, speeches to their countries, and like the Queen and Macron, and people have been putting up versions of it with the Independence Day president's speech playing behind there. And weirdly, it works with all of them.
Man, that was such a huge movie. I remember the release of that.
You must have been a baby.
I was, but I remember going. We went to the theater.
Anyway.
Yeah, that was 96. You know what?
I'm four, and I'm gonna see Independence.
I'm older than I look. But man, that must have been. Do you remember the opening weekend? Did you go see it? What do you do when a big movie comes out like that? Do you get excited or do you just hide away?
Well, you spend up to the point when you actually finish it being completely terrified. Because I used to go for a walk. It was on Santa Monica, and there was a sort of Mexican restaurant at the top of the hotel.
Exactly right.
And sometimes we go up there, but most of the time you go out once a day to walk just to get out of the room. Because it was, you know, say it was a suite, it's actually quite, there were two rooms. One was like a living room and one was a bedroom. The living room became your writing room and the bedroom is where you went when you
could write. And I do remember something you just said. I don't think you had more than, you know, it felt like they were sort of two Yamaha DX7s and a Roland synth
I can remember exactly what was in those racks.
Old Mac. It just was so, to think now when you walk into a composer's
studio. It wasn't a Mac, it was an Atari.
Oh my God, it was so low budget. The whole thing was, can you write?
I had 16 channels of MIDI. Oh,
and you wrote a massive score on this rented gear.
Well, yeah, it was partly that, and then partly when you go to sort of full orchestration with Nick is then like, you know, doing the, you know, expanding it so you actually do, you know, voice the brass properly, because you've got, obviously on paper, you don't have to worry about not hearing anything. But
would you go out for your walk and get inspiration?
Go out for the walk. And then I remember watching helicopters were flying up and down the beach in Santa Monica with, you know, trailing these things saying the world ends July the 4th. And buses going past with all the posters on it. And you realize you were still in the middle of writing it. And I think there's only so many of those huge things you can do. I mean, some people seem to do a lot of them, but I always found it actually takes quite a lot out of me. And I think maybe it's because you're doing it all in a room and you never get away from it. And, you know, when the point when you stop writing at whatever it is, 1 o'clock in the morning, and you know that it's only 6 hours before you start again, and that stuff is in that other room and you can see it glowing, you know, and you can hear it humming, and it sort of keeps saying, come back, come back, come back. And it's quite debilitating in a lot of ways, I think, you know. I mean, it's interesting that, you know, technology has allowed us to do a lot of things in a lot of different places. Soon after that, I ordered like 7 or 8 big flight cases, because I thought, like, if I'm going to come here and do this a lot, you know, I need to get a bit more kit together. So anyway, I ordered this, you know, big flight case system with everything was multi-cored up, and it made everything much easier. And literally about a year after I got that, the internet turned up and everything got faster, and people were turning up for writing sessions with a drive, and they'd rent a computer when they got to LA. So, I mean, the whole thing sort of changed.